Hey, it's Raj from 3CB Performance. Barcelona and Argentine legend Lionel Messi needs no introduction. He's arguably the greatest to ever lace them up. One of his most jaw-dropping abilities comes from set pieces and the ability to deliver stunningly precise free kicks from all over the pitch. In this video, I'll break down the key elements of Messi's free kick from run-up to follow-through and mind-body feedback. The angle Messi takes to the ball generally varies depending on the distance and side of the free kick. The nearer and towards the right the free kick placement, the flatter, more acute his angle tends to be. Whereas the further or towards the left placement, the less acute the angle. Messi will vary the run-up angle to keep teams and keepers off the scent. The final sequence of Messi's run-up nearly always consists of a short stride with his right leg, short stride with his left leg, and then a long stride third step to plant the right foot next to the ball. This step pattern does two things. Firstly, it creates a rhythm, which allows his free kick muscle memory to take over and mitigate external interference, crowd noise, environment, etc., and internal interference, anxiety, pressure, negative self-talk, etc. This is scientifically referred to as, quote, motor priming or priming the system. Secondly, the elongated final stride and firm plant with his right foot creates a firm base of support and balance, with Messi engaging the muscles along his entire right leg, hip, core, and trunk, and longer swing through distance for his left leg. The result is increased power and control on his strike. There are instances where he'll vary the initial step-ups of his run-up. For example, using a staggered stance with his right foot forward to substitute for the first short right stride, or taking many steps prior, but it always ends with a short right, short left, long right pattern. The early variations may again be to deceive the opposition. As Messi swings through and makes contact, it's almost as if he's falling away from the ball. That position unlocks arguably the key piece of Messi's free kick, hip mobility. With his hips shifted to the right, his left hip and leg are now in abduction, moving away from midline, external rotation, outward rotation, and flexion coming upwards. This position of abduction, external rotation, flexion is the quote open packed position of the hip, which allows for the highest amount of hip mobility, namely because the hip ligaments are put on slack. This distinctive technique allows Messi to open up his hip to an unheralded range, get around the ball to make clean contact with his instep, more on that in a second, and generates more power by maximizing a quote elastic recoil effect with key muscles, namely the adductors and internal rotators, in which these muscles are first stretched out like a spring and then recoil to generate significant force as he swings through. Messi uses prototypical instep form to lock his left ankle and foot to create a rigid lever for transferring energy to the ball and create a platform for generating power and spin. Generally, spin comes from the contact point and follow through. Their side lateral spin, which creates left to right movement, and top anterior spin, which creates dipping movement. What sets Messi's free kicks apart is his ability to modulate the two spins. Whether Messi is striking the ball centrally to create more dip and balance top spin with side spin, or he's trying to sharply curl the ball by generating heavy side spin, he's able to get around the ball with an open hip, make contact and rub through his instep diagonally. He has an uncanny ability and feel to almost scoop the ball, which allows him to further shape the curve and manage a short, controlled, balanced follow through so his legs and hips don't interfere with any of the work that he just did. Look at how quiet his lower body is here after the strike. Lastly, and I wanted to point this out because it's almost ridiculous, as Messi's follow through carries him to the right, he essentially rolls off his right ankle to maintain a smooth thrust. If I couldn't see the rest of the picture, I think this is a picture of someone spraining their ankle. Extraordinary balance, mobility, and control. As Messi makes contact with the ball, he angles his torso downwards to create a V-like effect between his upper and lower body. Keeping the chest down does two main things. Firstly, it prevents him from opening up too early and getting underneath the ball to sky it. Secondly, it creates a lower center of mass, which increases balance and stability. After Messi picks where he wants to place the ball, his eyes lock in on his strike point, and his steady short run-up limits head movement. These two factors allow for increased visual time, clarity, and focus on that strike point. This is critical because vision transmits a ton of information to the brain during movement, especially to optimize balance, and increasing research is showing that in target sports like football, the more time the eye spends on relevant factors, the strike point in this case, the better the outcome. For more info on that, look up quote, quiet eye training. After Messi strikes the ball, his eyes continue to track the ball in flight all the way into the net. This may seem basic, but it's actually quite important because it's a key feedback and learning mechanism. Every time Messi strikes the ball and tracks it, whether it's during practice or during a game, he's unconsciously processing the results of his movements, connecting it back to the movement sequence and storing that within his internal movement database. I think of it as a constant feedback loop. An example of this in a different sport is Golden State Warriors guard Stephen Curry, arguably the greatest shooter of all time, who after releasing a jump shot, tracks the flight of the ball all the way to the eventual outcome. Lastly, Messi's free kick sequence, from run-up to body shape to the strike to follow-through, is very compact and consistent. This results in less variables to control, which means less variance in the movement and greater consistency, effectiveness, and added deception. This repeatability is a common theme shared by the best free kick takers in the world. That's a wrap for this video. Thanks for watching. My goal is to provide you with in-depth, evidence-based, narrative-free analysis. You can always find me on IG and Twitter at 3CB Performance. Please take care of yourselves and follow the appropriate precautions to limit your exposure to and spread of COVID-19. Make sure to sub to the channel and follow along on all social media for latest updates. 3CB out.